Welcome to part one of a video tutorial series on electric lighting simulations in ClimateStudio. In this tutorial, we will review how to add luminaires to a simple office model and run a point-in-time illuminance simulation in the Rhino interface. This model is made available so you can follow along with this video series. With Rhino open and our simple office model in perspective, let's select the point-in-time illuminance workflow. Luminaires can also be simulated in the Radiance Render workflow, where luminaires and their lighting zones can be adjusted post-simulation. I'll leave my location as is, but you should update this according to your site's location. The sky panel is where the sky luminance distribution is defined. First, select the type of sky model to be used. Second, adjust the month, day, and hour. For electric lighting only simulations, the hour filter should be set to 0 or midnight. Ground albedo can also be changed here. In the Materials panel, ensure your layers have been assigned a material. Let's also quickly add our required simulation grids to the model. I'm going to simulate three rooms with different use cases that will determine our lux targets for the electric lighting simulation. The northwest room will be a computer laboratory with a target lux of 400. The northeast room will be an open concept office space with a target lux of 500. And the southeast room will be a communal kitchen area with a target lux of 300. Navigate to the Luminaires panel and hover over the Add Luminaire button. Click Browse to search through ClimateStudio's library of IES files. You can also select your own downloaded IES file here. I'll choose a lensed troffer luminaire. My selected IES file is visualized three-dimensionally as a photometric web in horizontal and vertical cross-sections. The power multiplier field lets you scale the luminaire's total brightness. Set the lamp color using an RGB or CCT value. I'll change the lighting zone to Zone A, Northwest Computer Lab, then click Place in Rhino Model. Zooming in on the Northwest Computer Lab room, I'll click where I want to place the luminaire. It should be placed below the ceiling surface. I can then select the luminaire and use the array command to copy and paste the luminaire throughout the office space. I will create 6 in the X direction and 3 in the Y direction. Notice that these luminaires are now listed under Zone A in the Luminaires table. I can also see the count, lumens, IES file name, and turn on or off the horizontal and vertical webs. This is also where you can check on or off the post-processing box for the Radiance Render workflow. Let's add luminaires to the northeast open concept office room. Click on Add Luminaire again. This time, I'll select a parabolic troffer luminaire. I'll change my lighting zone to Zone B, northeast office. I'll once again move the luminaire just below the ceiling and use the array command to create an evenly spaced group of luminaires in this room. I'll repeat this process one more time for the northeast communal kitchen room. Now, let's run the simulation. Press Start. Hover over the simulation grids to see specific sensor metrics. In the Legend and Settings menu, I can turn on the Sensor Point Value tags to determine if my rooms met my required lux targets. Sensor metrics can also be exported as a table. In part 2 of this series, we will review how to perform an electric lighting simulation in Grasshopper. Part 3 then explains how to take this a step further and perform a parametric electric lighting simulation in Grasshopper. Thank you for watching and happy simulations!